I call Mojo Mathis.
I would like to focus my comments in support of the SOP with the Assistant Secretary, designation of the Race Relations Commissioner and the Equal Opportunities Commissioner, as well as that of the Disability Rights Commissioner. And I want to thank and acknowledge the Māori Party for lobbying and enabling that change, and to the Minister for listening and bringing this SOP to the heart. The SOP addresses one of the major concerns that the Green Party and many submitted had about the bill, which the Minister of the time refused to address. And it was clear to me from listening to the many submissions that the removal of the specific titles was perceived by the community that these commissioners support as a lessening of their roles and changing the specific special character and focus and visibility of these roles. And that, so the change in this SOP, I would say, is not minor. It is significant. It is significant because titles do matter. And for each of the priority areas of the Human Rights Commission, it is vital, in our view, that the titles of the commissioners do reflect these priority areas. Specific designations not only create clarity and increase visibility, they affirm the critical importance of these issues to the groups represented in a way that downgrading to generalised commissioners leading the areas of priority does not. And this is because the priority areas in the bill are just that, priority areas that really focus on the community where there is still a long way to go to ensure that their human rights are recognised. For disabled people, are among the most marginalised and discriminated people in New Zealand. They are underrepresented in employment and home ownership, are overrepresented in prison, face major challenges in accessing health and other services. Over 30% of complaints to the Human Rights Commission are related to disability. Gender issues are critical as ever, with record levels of domestic and sexual violence in this country and a significant pay gap for women in many sectors. And we see appalling, absolutely appalling levels of abuse and racism directed at Māori in this country on an almost daily basis. And so for all of these factors combined affirm it was absolutely not the time to be disestablishing the specialised designation for the Human Rights Commissioners. And I also want to put on record again that the move by the government to create the position of a disability commissioner was partly prompted by when a member's bill by my colleague Catherine Delahunty was pulled from the member's ballot in 2010. And that bill by Catherine established a designated disability rights commissioner to sit alongside the existing specialist designations of the Race Relations and Equal Employment Opportunity Commissioners. And it was long overdue, because for far too long, the needs and rights of disabled people have languished far behind that of other people, in part due to major structural and systematic barriers that disabled people face in this country, along with systematic negative attitudes and towards people living with impairment towards disabled people. And Catherine at the time withdrew her bill in the good faith when the government announced that they would be creating a disability commissioner, under the assumption that such a position would be created to stand alongside the existing designated position. And that is why we objected so strongly when it was found that the bill was going to go much further than that and actually restructure the commission and downgrade the specific designation. And So it's incredible, a huge relief, in fact, that this SOP now reinsert the specific designation.
Mojo Mathis.
Thank you.
No, do you
want
to keep going?
I'll call David Shearer.